Miss me? I've been really busy traveling all over Europe, downgrading companies, downgrading countries, downgrade here, downgrade there, everywhere downgrade, downgrade, E-ya-e-ya-o. Well, if you're watching the stock market, you will realize that last week we had a major sell down all over. Okay, and right now, what happened? Welcome to Weekly Singapore Stock with Jonathan. Today is 26th of November 2011. Market major sell downs and all over, and S&P has been going down and down. In fact, I think this week we lost about 5% if I remember correctly. And on Friday, it was half a day. Thursday was a holiday. And Dow Jones went up but couldn't help on to the gains, because I believe Hungary got downgraded, Belgium also got downgraded. The news somewhere about here. Well, you can check out the news. It's all over. You read the newspaper, you read, watch the Channel 5 news or Channel News Asia news, you notice that everywhere newspaper all saying market is so gloomy. The bears are very strong. Kept on attacking the market. So it seems like end of the world is about here, isn't it? Well, we shall see. Now, if you take a look and watch S&P, you will realize that S&P did something that everyone was expected. Now, a lot of people say technical analysis is on hindsight. But if you watch and follow my website, chartingacademy.com, you realize that 1 week ago, I posted that the projection downside for S&P on Sunday, posted Sunday, November 20th, that this is projection downside for the symmetrical triangle is going to reach 116.95 to 115.8. Well, S&P hits 116.3. Okay, on Friday, low volume, because Friday is only half day, and it displays an inverted hammer. Okay, now, what's going to happen to the market? Let's take a look. S&P right now, if I use the Fibonacci levels right here, S&P right now is a very crucial 61.8% Fibonacci support. Very crucial. Break that. Okay, very simple fact. Market is weak. Okay, market is extremely weak. So right now, the thing is, we're going to watch to see whether there could be a short-term rebound. If it doesn't rebound, it's going to collapse further. Okay, this is the last line of defense. Basically, US right now is on the last line of defense. But overall, everywhere around the world, the market is weak. Okay, now it hit the projection downside for the symmetrical triangle. And like it or not, we are all under the 20, the 50, the 100, and the 200 day moving average. So price right now, all below the moving average, tells you market is bearish. Really, really bearish. That's why you look at the news, everywhere is all gloomy. The only thing is, I find that too many people are too bearish right now. Okay, maybe I'm contrarian. I'm expecting a bounce. We shall see. Okay, let's analyze the whole market, then you take a look. Now, let's take a look at Euro US dollars. Do take note about Euro US dollars. Now, I drawn a line from this low to this low, connected together. This is what we call a trend line support. If I zoom in very closely, you will notice that right now we are very, very close to the trend line support. Now, this trend line support means very simple. For those of you who do not know Forex really well, this chart up means stock market up. This chart down means stock market down. This is Euro US dollars daily chart. So we're coming close to a potential support in Euro US dollars. Okay, now let's take a look at regional market, Shanghai. Okay, Shanghai, it broke the Fibonacci support. If you watch the Thursday, Wednesday night webinar, okay, webinar recording, you realize that I said that market right now is at the Fibo 61.8%. We broke. Okay, Shanghai broke the 61.8%. We broke. But the only thing right now didn't confirm. So there's tiny, tiny hope. Bull got tiny, tiny hope. Well, it's bear. Bearish market. But bull just have one last hope. Okay, that means I'm looking very closely to Monday, Tuesday. Okay, I'm jumping around. I'll give you a whole summary in a short while. Now, support to watch out for in Shanghai. Okay, Shanghai support is 2310. Shanghai must not break the 2310. In fact, if you take a look historically, let me remove this so it's easier to see. Shanghai right now is at 2380. Let's take a look. Yeah, 2380. Let me zoom into this particular area. Is the resistance on February 17, 2009. It is also the support on 28th of April 2009. So perhaps right now Shanghai could be at, it's a weak support, but potentially it is still could be bouncing right here. We'll see. Now the market is really close. Okay, we are close to the breaking down. The support that Shanghai must not break is the 2310. Okay, now Hang Seng is hanging on to the Fibonacci support. Today I'm going to use a lot of Fibonacci. Hang Seng is right now hanging on. Yeah, it went below, but still hanging on there. It's at a Fibonacci 61.8%, which is about 17,730 thereabouts. And like it or not, we are way below the 20, the 50, the 100, 200. Market is bearish. One word, market is bearish. The only thing right now is, the only hope for bull, okay, is the selling downs. The volume is decreasing. So if you are still in the bull market, do take note. First, you are counter trend because right now it's bear already. Second, hopefully the selling pressure are decreasing in Hang Seng. Hopefully, it's hope. We are using a lot of hope analysis right now. Okay, hopefully that there will be a perhaps a Christmas rally or year end rally. We don't know. Okay, now I'm jumping around. Let me finish this and summarize later. Hang Seng selling down, but the volume is decreasing. So we shall see whether is it selling pressure decreasing. We don't know yet, but let's see. Now, due to popular request, I'll be watching the FBM KLCI. Now, in FBM KLCI, did you notice that it was resisted by the 100-day moving average? That 100-day moving average is also some major significance. If I draw the Fibonacci resistance, this is a resistance line. Did you notice that at that level is also the 61.8% Fibonacci resistance, which is together with the 100-day moving average at the same level? So that's why resistance plus resistance, more resistance. Now, at right now, guess what? FBM KLCI is the strongest indices in this region, because the rest, Hang Seng broke through, barely support 61.8% supporting it. Hang Seng cracked 61.8. Singapore later you notice also cracked 61.8. But FBM KLCI is holding at 38.2% Fibonacci support. So in terms of regional indices, FBM KLCI is stronger than Hang Seng, stronger than Singapore, stronger than Shanghai. Okay, right now is holding at 38.2% support. Granted, I agree that Friday candlestick wasn't bullish. Okay, Friday candlestick wasn't bullish. So we shall see whether it will go and take out this 1423 level, which is coincidentally the hammer low, hammer candlestick low right here. Okay, so we shall see. The only thing is right now is exactly well close. You look at chart, if you want precise, it closed below the 50-day. But it's so close, we put it as a question mark. Alright? Now, Straits Times resisted by the 100-day, as previously you noticed it was in the webinar and YouTube. It broke below the 61.8, so the 61.8 Fibonacci already cracked. We are not going to use the Fibonacci levels anymore. The next support, if you're going to watch Straits Times, is we can only hope. Now it's a lot of hope analysis, that this window is going to hold up Straits Times. From these levels, about 2620, to 2606. So we're going to watch to see whether this level, this window, is going to hold up straight times. Okay, we shall see. Like it or not, right now, S&P, Hang Seng, Shanghai, Malaysia, and Singapore, we are now in oversold territory. How do I know? Very simple. Turn on the stochastic indicator. You will notice right now, stochastic, alright, it's below 20%. These are considered a sign that is oversold. Okay, it's a sign that's oversold. So we are right now in oversold territory. If you're on a short, you have to understand that you're taking a higher risk. Can the market go down? Yes, oversold can always stay oversold. But as of now, to short is going to be higher risk. To long, no signal. Okay, now let's go to banks. Banks, oh, banks are weak. The only strongest bank right now are DBS. Well, take a look, it's oversold. Basically, a lot of counters right now oversold. That's in summary. Banks are the strongest. DBS are among the strongest because on Friday, it tried to form an inverted hammer. Granted, inverted hammer is quite weak, but it is still a inverted hammer. Okay, compared to OCBC, it closed day low. Okay, broke below the recent Thursday, Wednesday support. Compared to SGX, it broke below Thursday low compared to UOB. Okay, so DBS never broke below Thursday low. So possible DBS could be the strongest as of now. But banks are weak. Okay, next one, you're going to give me a lot of heat. Commodities.
Noble. Hi-yo.
Noble. Let me repeat. You watched the webinar on Wednesday night, Thursday after Thursday morning. Bullish reversal candlestick, no confirmations. Inverted hammer on Thursday, on Friday, no confirmation. It closed day low at $1.1055. Okay, $1.055. As of now, no reversal signal in Noble Group. Don't put too much hope in Noble Group. Okay, don't put too much hope in Noble Group. Okay, some people say conspiracy. Okay, fine. Okay, let's take a look at conspiracy theory then. If some people mention that conspiracy theory, all the big boys were buying here, one very simple question, ask yourself, all the big boys right now are losing money. Right? So can it push the market higher? Possible. But right now, if you said all the big boys are buying here, okay, I can tell you all the big boys right now are losing money. Very simple fact. The price is below that particular candle when it gets down. Okay? Now, commodities, first resources, highlighted previously, be careful. Okay? Because first resources, look at the candles, very narrow range. The volume are decreasing. It tells you that the buying pressure is decreasing. It also have bearish divergence. Okay, it also have bearish divergence in first resources. No, not in stochastic. Okay, so it has bearish divergence. So be careful if you're holding first resources. If we break below perhaps 142, you might be thinking about taking some profit off. Okay, now Olam, no signal. Olam do not have any signal too long. Sakari do not have any signal at all. Basically, a lot of counters got no signal. Now, Marines, be careful about Costco. Costco broke the recent support, came down. I believe why it broke is also because of Yang Zijiang. Be very careful. The volume in Yang Zijiang increased on Friday together with Black Candle. But why? What's so careful about Yang Zijiang? It broke down from the Bollinger Squeeze. So that means there are potential that Yang Zijiang may continue to the downside. So be very careful if you've got long position in Yang Zijiang. Keppel Corp and Sem Corp are holding right there. Let me change my indicator back. Keppel Corp are holding at support together with Sem Corp. Holding at support. Sem Corp is holding at a support of $4. Okay. Keppel Corp holding the support at about 888555. Okay, Chinese number likes to remember it. Okay, we stick it at 555, $8.88. The only thing you have to be careful about Sem Corp and Keppel Corp. Why? Because Sam Marine broke down. So a lot of counters broke down. Okay, NOL, be very careful, because right now NOL could be forming a bearish pennant. As long as NOL cannot go above this black candle, NOL is still bearish. Okay, NOL must go above this black candle. Plantations signal in Wilma failed. Wilma broke below the $5 support. Wilma failed support. Golden Agri, no signal. Indo Agri came lower. Anyway, Indo Agri do not have any signal at all. Okay, because previously Wilma had a signal because it was bullish because of this hammer. It was also quite bullish because of this hammer, but confirmation failed. Okay, because it closed below $5. Properties, CapitaLand, be very careful and watch. If you entered long position CapitaLand, watch that CapitaLand do not go below $2.41. Be very careful if CapitaLand go below $2.41. The only good news right now is CapitaLand, the black candle here and the Thursday candle are all low volume. Maybe the selling pressure wasn't strong, but buying pressure did not come in. Okay, CityDev, I am not sure. Okay, I don't know. I have no information, no news. I tried to search for gossip news. I couldn't find much. But CityDev is extremely weak. Okay, CityDev is extremely weak. CityDev used to oscillate together with Straits Times. But right now, CityDev is way, way weaker than Straits Times. Perhaps CityDev is going to come closer to the double bottom. Yeah, about there. Double bottom support at maybe about $8.72. Perhaps. Okay. Together with CapitaLand. CapitaLand is also coming close to the double bottom support at about $2.30. Double bottom support. Okay. But CityDev is very weak. Very weak. FNN, bearish divergence. So be very careful. FNN still cannot break higher than the resistance, a strong resistance at $6.30 here and now here. Maybe it could be consolidating. Maybe it could be forming a very small ascending triangle. But as of now, we do not know yet. Unless $6.30 break higher, price go higher than $6.30. But as of now, this is just consolidating, no signal at all. Okay. Yen lot, previously highlighted, be very careful on yen lot. Yen lot indeed broke down because it has a shooting star lookalike resisted by the 200 day moving average. Price of yen lot collapse. Next, SIA, be very careful because SIA broke below the strong support at $10.30. Bear flag is already in play as previously highlighted. So be very careful of SIA. Potentially SIA, now price will not come down in one straight line. Okay, but the projection of this bear flag may tell you that in the future there is a possibility that SIA may go down to $7. Okay, $7.30 to about $7.60. Be very careful on SIA. Potentially in future, we do not know. You'll see whether in 1 year, 2 years, maybe it happens. We shall see. Price don't come down in one straight line. Now, the casino of casino, Genting. Yoo-hoo. Okay. Genting right now are bearish. All the bullish reversal, this bullish engulfing signal, didn't happen. The bullish inverted hammer, no confirmations. So basically, price of Genting are bearish. Okay, volume came in on Friday, the sell down. Maybe it will bounce at about $1.42. But the next price to look out for Genting would be at $1.30. Okay, do look out for Genting at about $1.30. A short term bounce, not a long term bounce. Okay, previously highlighted Singtel. Let's say Singtel had a bearish divergence. Do watch my previous video if you'd like to find out more. Singtel came down. Okay, Perhaps Singtel could be bouncing at the 200-day moving average, but I don't put too much hope because 200-day moving average, you notice, already touching a lot of times. So if it does break lower, maybe the support will not be strong at 200 days for now, because it touches the 200-day way too many times. Okay, so if you'd like to find out more, do remember to go to chartingacademy.com. Okay, Charting Academy is where I post my stock tips, my outlook for the market, everything right there. Oh, by the way, I forgot. Summary. Overall, market are bearish. Really bearish. And if you're thinking about longing right now, okay, market could be bouncing because market right now are in technical oversold. We could be having a technical rebound. Previously, I said that this bounce could be a continuation of higher low. Yeah, it is a higher low if it happens to be the bounce. But this bounce so far, the market are weak. The market are very afraid of what's happening in Europe. So the market are weak. So this bounce right now, potentially, it may be against the trend. This long position could be against the trend. So be very, very careful. Be careful on that. Okay? Now, market oversold, maybe the bounce. The bounce, if it happened, it must happen by Monday or Tuesday. If not, S&P, the support is going to crack. If S&P, the support is going to crack, the whole Asia market is going to crack. So, I'm going to watch and see. Remember, oversold can stay oversold. Alright? So, always, I'll be posting my outlook, my tips in chartingacademy.com. Do introduce your friend to this website to help them learn more about technical analysis. And, Dream First 8 also are up. Whenever I find good videos, I will also constantly be updated it. And I learned something new. Lesson learned for a friend of mine. Do not promise your friend that you will give 1 trillion rupiah, because 1 trillion rupiah is equivalent to 1.44 million Singapore dollars. Some people say rupiah very small, right? But when you say 1 trillion rupiah, it's actually quite a big amount. So do take note. Okay? Alright. So this ends the YouTube for this week. So be very careful. Be safe in your trading. Thank you. Hi. Do you miss me? I've been busy working last week. I've been traveling all over Europe, downgrading countries, downgrading companies, moving here, moving there, everywhere, where, downgrade, all over. And what happened? Well, ouch. Ooh. Okay. Well, if you've been watching the stock market really closely, you know that over the last week, market have been one major sell down. Okay, welcome to weekly webinar with Jonathan. Okay, let's start again. Now, what happened? Welcome to weekly. Welcome to weekly Singapore stocks with Jonathan. Okay.